This is ABC7 News at 5:30. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Welcome back. Now you see it. Now you don't. A head-turning business sign is no longer up outside of a new Burns Court hair salon near downtown Sarasota. The salon owner says the city made him take it down. ABC7's Ray Collins is joining us with an explanation. Ray.
Haley, the sign went up last July and came down last week. Salon owner Derek Donovan admits he put this sign up not knowing he needed a permit. Well, it didn't matter. The city said that style of monument sign is against the rules. So it is now gathering dust on the salon second floor. Despite the frustration, Donovan says the city has its rules and he respects that.
So you understand where the city's coming
from? Absolutely. That was never in question.
Do you think they're pro-business then?
I'm out on that one still. Because the sign was beautiful. If my building was facing that side street or that side street, I could have the sign. So I'm about 40 feet off. This is called a primary road. You can't have monument style signs. If I was on the secondary road, I could have the sign.
Donovan says he was told other signs like that in the area were grandfathered in. We asked the city spokesman for comment this morning, but we're still waiting. Haley?
All right, thank you, Ray. A follow-up now on the effort to combat the heroin crisis across the country and on the Suncoast. Over the weekend, President Obama signed legislation that will help fight drug abuse. The bill directs $500 million to anti-drug program grants within the Department of Health and Human Services. The money will be used to beef up drug abuse treatment and prevention programs, to better train healthcare practitioners, and improve prescription monitoring. According to the CDC, heroin-related deaths nearly quadrupled between 2002 and 2013. Suncoast Congressman Vern Buchanan backed this drug abuse funding bill. Progress continues in the fight against human trafficking on the Suncoast. This year alone, Sail of Freedom says it's seen more than 1,000 girls. The nonprofit works with State Attorney Ed Brodsky, First Step Addiction Treatment, and the Sarasota Police Department to give victims of human trafficking, get them in touch with the resources they may need. It's the very first prostitution diversion program in the state. They tell us it's all about shifting the mentality from viewing these people as criminals to instead looking at them as victims.
It's very important to make them feel comfortable because a lot of times the women that we serve don't see themselves as the victim.
We were arresting the victims. We were re-victimizing the victims, and it was changing that mindset.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, we talked to a victim whose case became the first in Sarasota where the suspect was found guilty and sentenced for human trafficking. Donald Trump's inner circle continuing to take shape. The president-elect today naming retired four-star Marine General John Kelly as his pick to lead the Department of Homeland Security. But Trump continues to tweet about Russia's alleged hacking and the impact it may have had on the U.S. election. ABC's Karen Travers is in Washington with the latest.
Growing calls for a thorough investigation into Russia's hacking during the presidential campaign. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell was blunt.
The Russians are not our friends. It defies belief that somehow Republicans in the Senate are reluctant to either review Russian tactics or ignore them.
The White House wouldn't comment on what Russia's motives may be, but the president's spokesman drew a line between the Kremlin's interference and President-elect Donald Trump.
You didn't need a security clearance to figure out who benefited from malicious Russian cyber activity.
Over the weekend on Twitter and Fox News, Trump slamming a Washington Post report that Russia interfered in the election to give him an advantage.
I think it's ridiculous. I think it's just another excuse. I don't believe it.
Trump has never believed the Russian government was behind the hacking. This despite 17 known U.S. intelligence agencies concluding that the Russian government directed the hacking. A spokesman for the Kremlin today saying the charge, quote, has nothing to do with reality. This public showdown between the president-elect and the intelligence community is unusual, especially in light of this statement by Trump on Fox News when asked about his infrequent intelligence briefings.
You know, I'm like a smart person. I don't have to be told the same thing and the same words every single day for the next 8 years.
Some members of the Electoral College have asked the government for a briefing on Russia's election interference. The Clinton campaign said in a statement Monday it supports that effort, and the electors should have their questions addressed. Karen Travers, ABC News, Washington.
Florida's economy is growing, but probably not enough to solve the state's budget woes. State economists are drawing up forecasts to predict how much the state will collect in taxes. Governor Rick Scott will use the forecast to draw up budget recommendations for 2017. Economists expect the state's main budget account to grow 4% during the fiscal year that ends next June. And they're predicting growth slightly over 4% in the 2017-2018 fiscal year. And now for a check on our forecast, which is pretty warm, especially in comparison to the rest of the country. Let's head over to Bob.
Yes, it has been nice. Temperatures in the upper 70s to low 80s today. The only downside to our weather has been the fog, and that wasn't around all that long this morning. 74 degrees right now. Sunshine as the sun is setting. Winds out of the west at 5 miles an hour, and the pressure 30.07. Still high, and it looks like high pressure will remain in control despite the presence of a cold front moving through the lower Mississippi Valley. Right now, no cold temperatures to speak of. All above average at this hour, 74 in Jacksonville, same in Sarasota, 77 now into Miami, Orlando at 81 degrees. Right on the water, temperatures just a little bit cooler because of the water temperature now in the upper 60s there, but 75 in Inglewood, 78 in Northport, and 79 in Myakka City. We'll have more on the rest of the week's forecast coming up in just a few minutes. Haley.
Thank you, Bob. Police are releasing the names of two Byron, Georgia officers who were shot while serving a warrant. According to the Georgia Bureau of Investigation, a drug task force was serving the warrant on a drug case early this morning. Five officers went into the home while three stayed outside. A man inside the home shot at the officers. They returned fire, killing the suspect. Officer James Wynn was shot once in his vest and in his left arm. And Officer William Patterson was also wounded in the left arm. Both are expected to fully recover. A week of testimony and 5 hours of deliberations have brought a conviction in the killing of a former NFL star. Former New Orleans Saints player and Super Bowl winner Will Smith was shot and killed after a road rage incident in New Orleans last April. The gunman, Cardell Hayes, testified on Saturday that he shot Smith in self-defense, but the jury did not believe him. Yesterday, jurors came back with a manslaughter conviction.
At the end of the day, it's not a win. Losing a man and another young man going to jail, you know, that kind of tells you what situation it is. You know, so in that sense, it's a loss for everybody.
Cardell Hayes now faces up to 40 years in prison. Hayes will be sentenced on February 17th. The New Orleans District Attorney says he will seek a 60-year sentence. And still to come on your Suncoast News, treatments for hepatitis C. The medication's now available for those living with the virus. And a warning for all of you mac and cheese lovers, which brands are being recalled because of salmonella concerns. That's next.
Don't miss the 19th annual Thunder by the Bay Motorcycle Festival, January 5th through the 8th, to benefit Suncoast Charities for Children. This year's festival welcomes special guest Blue Oyster Cult to the premier sports campus at Lakewood Ranch on January 8th at 4 p.m. Admission is free. Festival events include a sporting clay tournament, kickoff party, welcome Thunder event, cruise for cash, charity motorcycle ride, and a two-day rockin' and riding at the ranch festival featuring vendors, live music, a Taste of Thunder area, and more. VIP tickets are available. For tickets and info, visit thunderbythebay.org.
Selling your home? Insist on a 3D showcase tour from Gulf Shores Realty. Virtual tours are flat and boring and look more like a slideshow than a tour. A 3D tour from Gulf Shores Realty is like actually walking through the home without the drive. Get instant access to your next home from any device. Multiple views give homebuyers a perspective like no other. For a limited time, mention ABC7 and Gulf Shores Realty will provide a complimentary 3D tour with your new listing.
Types of timber, cuts of meat, cooking times, temperatures, rubs, seasonings, sauces. You name it, they know it. That's what makes them who they are, Sonny's Pitmasters, and proud of it. Come get some baby back ribs at Sonny's Barbecue. On their own or paired with favorites like jalapeno cheddar hot links or pulled or sliced pork plus two sides and bread. Sonny's Barbecue, local Pitmasters since '68.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Alex Karras Lincoln's holiday sales event is here. Drive a brand new 2017 Lincoln MKC Sports Utility for $269 per month or a 2017 MKZ for $299 per month. We are proud to introduce the newest addition to the Lincoln lineup, the all-new 2017 Lincoln Continental. We have a great selection and ready for immediate delivery. Alex Karras Lincoln, affordable luxury. Winner of the prestigious 2015 President's Award, serving Florida's Sun Coast since 1978. We're located 2 miles north of the Sarasota-Bradenton Airport on US 41. Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
You may have seen the hepatitis C commercials advocating a cure. ABC7's Alex Redmond joins us with more on how far we have come in the treatment of hep C. Alex.
Thanks, Haley. Annual hepatitis C-related deaths in 2013 surpassed the total combined number of deaths from 60 other infectious diseases reported to the CDC. That includes HIV, pneumococcal disease, and tuberculosis. Hepatitis C is called the silent epidemic.
Unfortunately, people don't come into treatment soon enough because they don't have very many symptoms early on. But it can lead to liver cirrhosis, cancer of the liver, and has become the number one cause for liver transplantation in the United States.
130 to 150 million people worldwide have chronic hepatitis C infection, according to the World Health Organization. And the CDC finds hep C kills more Americans than any other infectious disease. Boomers are at the highest risk.
The people born between 1945 and 1965. And in fact, that Medicare has now approved testing and screening of all this entire population and other insurance companies as well.
There are vaccines for both hepatitis A and B, but not hepatitis C, says Dr. Stephen Nicholas of Comprehensive Care Center, which is part of the Community AIDS Network. But there is hope.
And now we have new agents available that are a pill a day and close to a 95 to 99% cure rate.
Patients were taking a year of an injection medicine called interferon and a pill called ribavirin, says infectious disease doctor Tanya Schreibman.
That had a multitude of side effects that was almost like being on chemotherapy for people. And it was a 40 to 50% cure rate at that time.
Dr. Schreibman says that about 30% of people that are infected with HIV also have hepatitis C.
So when I got diagnosed with hepatitis C, it was called non-A, non-B hepatitis. They hadn't even had a name for it yet.
Valerie Wojciechowicz says she's been living with HIV and hepatitis C for 30 years.
If I were looking for symptoms, I wouldn't have had them. It's just fortunate that I took the test.
There's been so little progression in her body, says Wojciechowicz, that she never had to consider the old hep C treatments that people may still be reluctant to consider.
I'm on a 3-month course of treatment. It's one pill once a day for 3 months, period, end of story. And it's truly amazing. I've had some side effects, but they're minimal compared to the old school medications.
It is essentially a cure for hepatitis C, which is a marked change from where we've come in the past.
About 3.5 million Americans are living with hepatitis C, and roughly half are unaware of their infection. CDC and the U.S. Preventative Services Task Force recommends one-time hepatitis C testing for everyone born from 1945 to 1965.
And Alex, is there any research happening right here on the Sun Coast?
Yes, there is. The Comprehensive Care Center right here in Sarasota on Swift and Tuttle are conducting clinical trials right now, and they're actually recruiting. So we'll have some information for you on our website. Just go to mysuncoast.com and click on health.
It's fantastic. The strides we've already made and more still to come. All right. Thank you, Alex. Now let's head over to Bob.
Thank you, Haley. We're looking at a nice shot tonight over Sarasota Bay. Fairly calm out there. Some high clouds that were working their way in from the Gulf of Mexico. Sun has set, and we are looking for the possibility of some fog forming like we saw this morning. This photo coming from Twitter from the Sarasota Sheriff's Department indicating that some fog around area roadways in the morning causing the motorists to use caution, slow down a little bit, and remember not to use your brights when you have the fog because that caused more of the light being reflected back into your eyes and causing some problems with visibility. Here's the headlines. More morning fog tomorrow. A weak cold front arrives late Wednesday. Cools us down just a little bit, not much, and then a warm weekend. So a quick turnaround again. Highs will be above average by Saturday. Well, the radar picture showing some showers around to the east of us now and down to our south associated with a weak disturbance there. And some pretty heavy rainfall moving off toward Lake Okeechobee and some heavier showers down south along I-75 and Alligator Alley. All that again moving off to the east, not going to be a factor here. Through this evening, temperatures staying warm, 11 o'clock still at 67 degrees. The temperatures will be well above average for overnight lows. The high today was 79 degrees. That's well above the average of 74. This morning's low was warm at 68 and 26, the record low set back in 1957. No cold air headed our way anytime soon. Extreme cold air, just some slightly cooler temperatures I mentioned with the next front. Temperatures around some areas. Rosedale now 77 near State Road 79, 75. Waterleaf at 77. A bit cooler as you move closer to the coastline now. Low 70s from Anna Maria Island all the way down into Longboat Key. Now Whitney Beach at 72. Siesta Key a couple degrees warmer, 74. 76 degrees Lake Sarasota and 79 now in Northport. Port Charlotte at 78 and Inglewood at 75 degrees. Overnight, we're calling for low temperatures to be about 10 degrees above average. Some fog forming late tonight and tomorrow morning. That fog could be rather thick, and there may be advisories issued by the National Weather Service for low visibilities below a quarter of a mile. 74 degrees in Jacksonville currently at 77 in Miami, and temperatures around some of the cities. In Northport again at 77 degrees, Cortez at 72, and the Gulf of Mexico water temperature now it's 69 degrees, and that's taken at the end of the Venice Pier. Well, the story over the weekend was the heavy snowfall. That is now, for the most part, over, although snow is still occurring. Lake effect snows along the shore there of New York, as well as into the northeast United States. But all in all, the heavy snow is over. There are three major airports reporting delays now, up to about a half hour to an hour into Boston, also LaGuardia in New York, and also New Jersey. Now, some showers approaching the Louisiana. This is the big chill that's going to be taking place over the next couple of days. You can see what's happening. The cold Arctic air will stay mainly to the north of our area. These are the low temperatures, basically in the teens, and then as we move through time, high temperatures only into the single digits and teens on Thursday across the Great Lakes. More on that coming up at 6 o'clock. The future cast for us, fog around in the morning, burning off, and then we'll see a pretty nice day. Hopefully the sea fog burns off quicker, and then the front approaching looks like on in through late Wednesday, bringing with it some slightly cooler temperatures. Foggy conditions to start things off for boaters. Seas running 1 to 2 feet with a light chop out there. And then the extended forecast shapes up like this. Well, 74 for high on Thursday after that weak cold front moves through. And then warmer on Saturday and Sunday. Highs in the upper 70s to low 80s. Haley?
Thank you, Bob. Now to Suncoast Traffic Watch. No accidents right now, but I-75 is backed up a little in the northbound lanes near Fruitville Road in Sarasota. The Wells Fargo scandal is now implicating Prudential Financial. Wells Fargo admitted a few months ago that thousands of its employees had created unauthorized accounts for its customers. Now, Wells Fargo employees appear to have also signed up customers for Prudential life insurance policies without their permission. Three former Prudential employees are now suing the insurance company. If you're planning to have mac and cheese for dinner tonight, listen up. Some certain mac and cheese brands are being recalled because of the milk powder in the seasoning that could have salmonella contamination. The products included in the recall are Great Value macaroni and cheese from Treehouse Foods, along with Cheese Club and Big Win brands. So far, no illnesses have been reported. But if you have a box, you should throw it away or return for a refund. And some chips are also being recalled for possible salmonella contamination. Deep River is voluntarily recalling bags of its sour cream and onion kettle chips. The recall includes 2-ounce and 5-ounce packages with Best Buy dates from November 9th through June 2nd. Customers are being asked to throw out any affected chips. Entertainment news is coming up next.
Sarasota Jungle Gardens invites your family to the Holiday Light Spectacular select nights in December. Come enjoy dazzling light displays, live entertainment, and pictures with Santa. Tickets and information available at the door or online at sarasotajunglegardens.com.
Hi, I'm Chef Judy. Every Wednesday morning, I'll be with the chefs at the Publix Aprons Cooking School serving up the most wonderful dishes. Watch Aprons in the Kitchen every Wednesday on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Christmas Traditions by LuxArts Silks. Where more is merrier. Make your holidays sparkle with style. Browse our amazing showroom, cute collectible cottages, and beautiful Christmas displays. Find the inspiration, selection, and quality you need to deck the halls merry and bright. Christmas Traditions also features the area's largest selection of quality pre-lit Christmas trees. Every size, shape, and color. And plenty of decorations to make your home shine for the holidays. Christmas Traditions by LuxArts Silks. Where more is merrier. Visit us on New 301, just a quarter mile north of University Parkway.
They took that stress and that tension when I was particularly feeling very bad after that nasty car accident, and it was such a relief to know that I didn't have to bear that burden alone, that I had help.
Our goal is to not just get a satisfactory settlement on their case, we want them up on their feet, happy again. They've gotten their life back.
Kick off the season and find a unique holiday gift at the St. Petersburg Holiday of the Arts. Over 100 artists and thousands of works of contemporary art in photography, glass, sculpture, jewelry, and much more. The third annual St. Petersburg Holiday of the Arts, Saturday and Sunday, December 17 and 18th at South Straw Park in St. Petersburg. Bring your sense of discovery and appreciation of the beautiful at the St. Pete Holiday of the Arts. For more information, visit ParagonArtEvents.com.
Are you considering joint replacement or revision surgery? Consider this. Dr. Edward Stolarski has performed thousands of successful joint replacement procedures and trained surgeons from all over the world. Using advanced technologies, Dr. Stolarski is able to perform some of the most complex surgeries.
I wish I knew about Dr. Stolarski much sooner.
After the surgery, I don't have any pain. It's like I've got a 16-year-old hip.
My name's Ed Stolarski. What I really do is I give people back their life.
Schedule a consultation today.
Don't miss Sarasota Jungle Gardens Holiday Light Spectacular select nights in December. There's joyous music, roasting marshmallows, and festive family activities. Tickets and information available at the door or online at sarasotajunglegardens.com.
Oh, Merry Christmas!
La La Land leads the pack of 2017 Golden Globe nominations. The Los Angeles musical La La Land sang and danced its way to 7 nominations, the most. But the coming-of-age tale Moonlight is close on its heels with 6 nods. La La Land earned nominations for lead actors Emma Stone and Ryan Gosling, as well as Best Picture, Comedy, or Musical. The other nominees for Best Picture Drama are Manchester by the Sea, Lion, Hell or High Water, and Mel Gibson's Hacksaw Ridge. On the television side, The People vs. O.J. Simpson received 5 nominations. Meryl Streep could walk away with 2 awards from the Golden Globes. The actress received a nod for her role in the film Florence Foster Jenkins. Streep plays the title character and has been nominated for Best Performance by an Actress in a Motion Picture, Musical, or Comedy. But even if she doesn't win that one, Streep will be honored with the Cecil B. DeMille Award for Lifetime Achievement in the film industry, and she surely has that. The 22nd Critics' Choice Awards were handed out last night. Several films won multiple awards, including Jackie, which garnered Natalie Portman Best Actress honors, and Manchester by the Sea, which Casey Affleck took home Best Actor. But the film, again, La La Land, dominated the night. The musical took home 8 awards, including Best Picture, Director, Original Screenplay, Cinematography, Production Design, Editing, Score, and Song. Wow, way to go. In 2017, you can party all night long with Lionel Richie and Mariah Carey. The two superstars are kicking off their All the Hits tour in Baltimore on March 15th. Both Richie and Carey have a string of hits that are still popular today. Richie has won Grammys and Oscar and a Golden Globe. Carey is only behind Elvis for the most number one songs on Billboard's Hot 100 chart with 18. The tour will come to Tampa on May 26th, and tickets go on sale this Saturday. Everybody's excited about the premiere of Rogue One, the latest installment in the Star Wars saga. But one British father has taken his fandom to a whole new level. He built a huge backyard model of an Imperial Walker, a weaponized carrier used in the Star Wars movies. But one is a playhouse for his son. His team recreated every detail. Each joint and plate in the small model is replicated to the giant one. The head turns, the guns work, and you can even go inside. All of the items used to make the Imperial Playwalker Playhouse, they were ordered from eBay, which helped him make this video as well. And that is, I'm speechless. That's quite amazing. I'll be right back.